Welcome back to another episode of Your Daily Dose of Sports. On this day in history, back in 1927, Babe Ruth became the highest paid player in MLB history, signing a 3-year, $70,000 per season contract with the New York Yankees. It's official, Stephen Curry has been fully cleared for his return. He will come back from his 58-game absence tomorrow at home against the Raptors. It's about damn time. New York Islanders defenseman Johnny Boychuk required 90 stitches to repair a cut around his eyelid after being hit in the face by a skate Tuesday night. Team president Lou Lamoriello told reporters Wednesday Boychuk suffered no damage to his eye. He went on to say he had quite a night. He felt the skate blade hit his eye, but fortunately it just got the eyelid and it took 90 stitches to fix. He'll be fine. It's just a matter of time with the eye opening up. There is no timetable on his return. Thank God. I can't even imagine. Wishing him a speedy recovery. Trevor Bauer has been one of Rob Manfred's most vocal critics, but on Wednesday, the Cincinnati Red pitcher and the MLB commissioner met and the meeting was very productive, according to Bauer's Twitter. He went on to say, "I've been publicly critical of Rob Manfred before, but I have to give him props. He said he'd meet with any player who had further questions, and he was a man of his word this morning. We had a very productive meeting about a wide range of topics." Boston Red Sox star pitcher Chris Sale is not expected to undergo Tommy John surgery. Sale's elbow injury is still a major concern, and it's unknown how long the left-hander will be sidelined. ESPN continues to mic up players during spring training, and honestly, it's amazing content. Today, 2019 Rookie of the Year Pete Alonso was mic'd up, and let's just say Alonso may have dropped an F-bomb that I'm sure ESPN was not thrilled about.
You guys just get that. You just fucking smile at that.
Bit of a wild one here. Tottenham Spurs midfielder Eric Dier went into the crowd to confront a Tottenham fan on Wednesday night. Spurs midfielder reacted angrily to a comment and went to confront the fan after the game. From the video, it appears he chose to go into the crowd to defend his younger brother and had to be restrained by security. Tim Howard, the U.S. soccer legend, has announced he is coming out of retirement and is going to play for the Memphis 901, the USL team that he is a co-owner of. He went on to say, "Since my retirement in October, my obsession for football has grown," Howard said in a statement. "The desire to win continues to drive me. I love to play and I love to compete. This gives me the opportunity to do both." The Carolina Panthers made their first big deal under new coach Matt Rhule, agreeing to trade Pro Bowl right guard Trey Turner to the Los Angeles Chargers for left tackle Russell Okung. Okung will be reunited with new Carolina offensive line coach Pat Meyer, who was the offensive line slash run game coordinator for the Chargers from 2017 to 2019. Let's take a look at some of the top scores from across the day. Just a day after Liverpool was knocked out of the FA Cup, Tottenham has fallen to Norwich City 3-2 in penalties. Number 14, Villanova knocked off number 8, Seton Hall, and Texas A&M pulled off the upset versus number 17, Auburn. In the NBA, the Bucks beat the Pacers and the Mavericks won an OT versus the Pelicans. Our athlete of the night is Colin Sexton, who scored a career-high 41 points versus the Celtics. And I'll leave you with the highlight of the night, an insane no-look half-court shot from the Israeli Basketball League.
Goal!
Goal!